Welcome to Hard Talk.
I'm forever blowing bubbles, pretty bubbles in the air. They fly so high, nearly reach the sky. Then, like my dreams, they fade and die. Fortune's always hiding. I've looked everywhere. I'm forever blowing bubbles, pretty bubbles in the air.
I'm forever blowing.
Welcome Tony, who has gained the reputation for being a harsh realist.
Thank you for inviting me.
I would also like to welcome Hector, who is a political strategist for the Conservative Party. A warm welcome to Bill, who is a political strategist for the Democratic Party in the US. The theme today is bubbles. However, Tony, you believe that the global economy is facing a super bubble. Can you please explain?
In a nutshell, the Western countries are blowing up the largest debt bubble in history, and when it bursts, it will be unlike anything we have seen.
Tony, you should not be talking the economy down. What we need is to be positive and confident. People need to spend money so that the economy can grow.
So you don't think reality is important? Okay, Bill, how much is the US debt increasing per minute?
It's manageable.
So $3 million a minute of debt increase is manageable.
Here in the UK, we are applying austerity measures. We are paying down our debt.
So why are you continuing with quantitative easing?
Quantitative easing is applied to stimulate the economy.
Hector, please say it as it is. Quantitative easing is used to redistribute the wealth from the poor to the rich elite. Austerity measures will cause the economy to contract, as it will suffer the paradox of thrift. Therefore, the ruling elite pump money in the economy that is printed out of thin air. And believe me, I call this counterfeiting, as quantitative easing debases the money supply and causes price inflation.
Tony, I believe that you have a clip from a song you wish to play.
Yes, I believe it sums up the situation we face today.
Okay, here it is.
What a world! Ain't you glad you're a member of the human race? Now the folk singer came from America to sing at the Albert Hall. He sang his songs of protest and fairer shares for all. He sang how the poor were much too poor and the rich too rich by far. Then he drove back to his penthouse in his brand new Rolls Royce car. What a world! Ain't you glad you remember?
In the UK, the Prime Minister says that we are all in it together. The truth is that we are not. If we were all in it together, surely the banking elite would refrain from their massive bonuses.
Tony, are you against capitalism? Don't you believe in the free market?
Of course I believe in the free market, but we do not have a free market. It is crony capitalism.
Can you explain what you mean by that?
In 2008, the Troubled Relief Asset Program bailed out the banks, including YG. If we had a true free capitalist economy, the banks would have been allowed to fail. It would have meant a short, sharp depression, but the bailout has enslaved us to decades of misery, whilst at the same time the banking elite benefited from the cheap loans. For example, it is truly disgraceful that the RBS continued to pay massive bonuses to their senior staff, whilst at the same time it was partly public owned and making a loss.
Hector, do you have a response to that?
No.
The Occupy Wall Street movement have been branded as anti-capitalists by the mainstream media. They are not anti-capitalists. They just want to expose the scam of fractional reserve banking as it operates today.
In conclusion, Tony, how do you see the future for the Western economies?
It's very grim indeed. For the record, it is the 9th of March 2012 today. There is optimism sweeping through the US. They claim that the employment figures are encouraging. They forget to say that many Americans have taken up low-paid work and that many are on part-time hours. The EU are patting themselves on the back, as they claim that they have saved Greece from default by providing the bailout money.
For goodness sake, Tony, embrace the good news. It's people like you who talk down the economy that strike the fear of God into people.
Hector, you cannot ignore reality. Politicians are just kicking the can down the road. Trust me, we are at the end of the road. Greece will default and it will trigger the credit default swaps. Once that happens, it will have a domino effect throughout the Eurozone. The US won't be able to continue the illusion of wealth, as there will be a limit to how much the debt ceiling can be raised. Watch how things will unravel shortly after the presidential elections.
Thank you, Tony, and that's it from Hard Talk tonight. Goodbye.